It's now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Jared Cohon, President of Carnegie Mellon University.
Thank you, Randy. And let me acknowledge your wonderful leadership of the School of Computer Science in general, but also the leadership you provided that got us from a concept to the reality of these fantastic buildings. It was a great achievement. We're all grateful to you for what you've done. Thank you, Randy. Needless to say, it's a good thing we chose the largest venue on campus to hold this event at which Bill Gates will be speaking. There are 1,200 of you in this room. 1,200 tickets became available at time zero, and about time 23 hours later, they were all gone. As I informed Bill, or reminded Bill earlier today, at Carnegie Mellon, he is truly a rock star. And here you are to prove it once again. This is a very special occasion, of course, the day on which we formally dedicate the Gates Center for Computer Science and the Hillman Center for Future Generation Technologies. Bill, of course, has had a great deal to do with that, but he'd be the first to point out that many others have as well. As we look at the distinguished legacy of the School of Computer Science, and we just had a nice taste of the highlights in that video, we're aware that this is an historic day, not just for the School of Computer Science, but for all of Carnegie Mellon University. And I would add for all of Pittsburgh and Western Pennsylvania, because of the absolutely crucial role that this school plays in this university, and the role that this institution plays in this region and in the world. Our collaborative spirit has always been one of the university's great strengths. And we've undoubtedly seen over the years how the work of the School of Computer Science has contributed through that collaborative way of doing things, breakthrough advancements in many disciplines, in many fields, many of them that were mentioned already, like computational biology, computational finance, cosmology, fields that one doesn't think of necessarily when you hear the words computer science. But that's typical of the way this school has behaved and performed since its founding and even before. At the same time, in taking on these difficult problems in related fields, new areas of computer science itself have been opened up and the school has jumped in. This idea of connections, which Randy talked about, which the video talks about, which the book talks about, became the guiding principle for what has become a truly striking two buildings. They literally connect the campus from one end to the other. And the buildings in doing so strengthen the collaboration and our culture, which are so important to this university. The centers literally sit at a crossroads of the campus. You may not think of that now, but you will in short order, providing connections in every direction on the campus. And as you heard, one of those connections is the Pausch Bridge, named in honor of our beloved colleague. As a fitting tribute to Randy, who was passionate about the need for artists and technologists to work together, the Pausch Bridge extends between the School of Computer Science and the Purnell Center for the Arts. The bridge is a perfect example of how the Gates and Hillman Centers symbolize the collaborative, interdisciplinary way we do things at Carnegie Mellon, better than at any other university. But you know well, we would not be here today celebrating our remarkable history, and certainly not looking forward to using these outstanding new buildings, if it weren't for this superb support of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and the Henry L. Hillman Foundation. These gifts from these two foundations are part of a long and distinguished legacy of philanthropy at Carnegie Mellon that enabled our unprecedented rise to prominence as one of the world's most important universities. I thank the Gates Foundation and the Hillman Foundation I'd ask you to join me in doing so. There are many donors to this build, to these buildings beyond the Gates Foundation and the Hillman Foundation. I just want to single out one more. That's the McCune Foundation, which made a very substantial gift, but also did it at a time that was particularly important in terms of encouraging and inspiring our alumni to follow their lead. And we're very, very grateful for that. I also want to acknowledge the significant support that we received from Pennsylvania's Governor Ed Rendell, who worked in conjunction with Pittsburgh's Mayor Luke Ravenstahl to provide support for the new planetary robotics laboratory located in the Gates Center. And even though he's got a few things on his mind this week, we're very grateful that the mayor was able to join us today. Mr. Mayor, would you rise so we can acknowledge him? And sitting next to him, his partner in great things, not what some of you thought I was going to say, Allegheny County's County Executive Dan Honorato. Dan, would you rise? Thank you. These two gentlemen, more than most people in offices like theirs, really get it when it comes to the role of technology in economic development and the importance of that to the future of this region. I thank them for their ongoing support, which has been terrific. Randy showed you a slide listing the Turing Award winners who came from or are still with the School of Computer Science. Notably, Herb Simon and Alan Newell received their Turing Awards in 1975. That's a significant year because it was the same year in which a young Harvard student had his own revolutionary thoughts about technology and its future. That student embarked on what he later called, quote, a little extra project, writing software for the world's first personal computers. The little project, of course, became Microsoft, and the young student was, of course, Bill Gates. We're very delighted and proud that Bill would take his time to be here today. It's actually his second visit to Carnegie Mellon this year. The first one earlier this year was to our campus in Doha, Qatar, and now he's here in Pittsburgh, of course, to help us dedicate these wonderful buildings. Please join me in welcoming back Bill Gates.